Pinecone may look just like snow, but he can't hear the ho-ho-ho. And Santa Cat, he still believes we'll fog every day till Christmas Eve.
Say Merry Christmas!
Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. It is Christmas Eve right now, and I am going to be vlogging today, but I actually owe you guys two more Vlogmas videos, not just one. So one will be the vlog, and then today's video, I thought I would go over some of my goals for 2021, kind of my resolutions, but I like to think of them more as like yearly goals, even though it's kind of the same thing. I feel like resolutions a lot of times get broken, but goals you can work on even if you break them. Like you can continue growing with your goals. So that's just like a little mental game I play with myself, but I thought I would go over what my goals are for 2021. I think these are interesting to kind of verbalize and then look at the following year and see if you actually did anything. Last year, my biggest goal was to start making baby steps with cooking. And I would say I achieved it. I don't think I achieved it as much as I had hoped. So that is going to be a continuing goal for 2021. That is my first goal, and that is to continue making baby steps towards cooking. I did get gifted a couple of like easy cookbooks, cookbooks that involve like minimal ingredients, and I just feel like I need to just keep making progress towards it. I'm not a natural cook. I am not someone who enjoys cooking. I wish that I did, but I feel like as a mama, I need to have a few meals that I'm really confident with that I can whip together, and I'm just not there yet. I will say that HelloFresh has definitely helped with that because everything is pre-portioned, everything is given to you in that box, and you know that you have everything. I think that if you are trying to learn how to cook, that is a great way to go. It's definitely what I would consider baby steps. But I think for someone who's just not a natural cook and isn't interested in it really, is just doing it to kind of like better herself, because I feel like it's important as a mom. I feel like I did make baby steps. I want to make slightly bigger steps in 2021, maybe toddler steps. My second goal is to continue drinking zero Diet Coke for all of 2021. I am currently 7 months Diet Coke free. I do occasionally drink Sprite if I'm at a restaurant. I've actually talked about this trick in my giving up Diet Coke video. If you want to watch that video, I talk about why sometimes I have Sprite, but I didn't give up sodas. I just gave up Diet Coke because that's the only one that I had a problem with that I was addicted to and I wanted all the time. I don't crave Sprite, but I do like being able to have a Sprite if I'm at a restaurant or if I am getting fast food. Like the other day we had Pals, since we're here in Kingsport. It's a local restaurant. Blair used to work there. We love it. And they have peachy Sprite, and that's always been one of my favorite drinks from there. So I did get a peachy Sprite with my meal. I have started drinking water with some of my meals, which is a big step for me because I have always needed to have a bubbly beverage with my meals. That was Diet Coke for a long time. Then it switched to sparkling ice when I gave up Diet Coke. Then I started trying to drink bubbly, which is like a healthier carbonated water, flavored water. And now I really am trying, whenever I can, to just drink plain water with meals. If you are someone who drinks water with your meals already, you might think this is really weird that this is such a step for me, but it really is. I just feel like I need that bubbly flavored beverage with my meals, and it's been a step, but I am working on it, and I hope to continue that and continue zero Diet Coke for all of 2021. My biggest goal for 2021 is something that I have been working on for a very long time, and I'm still not there. I think that I'm better than I was. I think I made steps towards it in 2020, but that is going to be working on both my work-life balance and my work-work balance. And by that, I mean I do have two full-time jobs, essentially. Although I don't consider YouTube a job the way I used to, I still want to put all my time, like the appropriate amount of time, into it. So it's balancing YouTube versus my sticker shop, which is like my actual core job right now. And then also balancing both of those jobs against being a mom and being a wife and taking care of my family and spending time with my family and also spending time with myself. Self-care, reading the way that I love to do, that is my form of self-care. Just balancing that and having enough hours in the day. And that has been really hard for me because I do not feel like I have enough hours in the day. And I also don't feel like I ever have a good grasp on how to time balance those three areas of my life, my family, my YouTube world, and my sticker shop. And that's not even including like friendship and stuff like that. I feel like that kind of ties into like the family bubble. It's like my life's in thirds: YouTube, sticker shop, friends and family. I think that Skillshare has really helped with taking classes about productivity and time blocking and just different ways to organize your physical and your mental life. I have been loving taking classes on there. This is not sponsored, but I do have a link below if you guys want a free trial of Skillshare's premium membership. So I will have that in the information box. Again, not sponsored, but something that I've just really been enjoying, and they have classes on everything. So honestly, I feel like no matter what your 2021 goals are, you can find something that complements that on Skillshare. I've also considered trying to learn how to knit again. I went through a phase a couple years ago where I was obsessed with learning how to knit, and I haven't really done it since, but they have classes on knitting, so I'm considering trying to knit something simple. We'll see. But again, they just have classes on so many things, so I will have that link below if you guys want a free trial. Nothing to lose there. And then my wish list item, a goal that I have that I really don't have any control over, but I really hope happens for me in 2021, is to have a baby. I obviously have been on this infertility journey for a very long time, and I just really hope to have a 2021 baby. That is not something that I can control. We're doing our best. But that is something, come next year when I go to look back on this video, if that has happened, I'm gonna be so happy. And yeah, 2020L sitting in this chair wants that more than anything else. So I thought I'd put it in here even though I have no control and it's just a wish list item. I think you can have wish list items on your goals, that's okay. So those four things are my 2021 goals: no Diet Coke, learning to cook more, productivity / figuring out how to balance my life, and having a baby. I would love to hear what your goals are, the things that you're gonna strive for this year. If you wanna leave me a comment below, that would be amazing. And I am going to go ahead and show you a clip of the giveaway gift for today. Here is the giveaway gift for today. So inside, we have three items. So first you have this Cosmic Clay face mask. I thought this was really pretty. You get this rose quartz face and under eye roller. I have this exact same one. I love it. And you get this Opal House 2021 planner. It's absolutely beautiful. It has this tassel. It's a soft pink and it is so pretty. In order to enter, you need to be subscribed to this channel with the bell notification turned on. Leave me a comment below telling me what your goals are. And then for Instagram, I'll have all of the information over there. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I am going to go ahead and vlog the rest of today because, like I said, it is Christmas Eve. And yeah, I will see you guys in my next video. Goodbye.